Okay, so we should start.
Hello?
Right?
Timing?
This is good.
My name is Ryan R. Smith. I'm here from Troy, New York, and first of all, thanks to the New Music Gathering for including me, and to Christina Stanley. Daniel Steffi for helping out with this. So I'm going to do sort of two talks. The first one is the third in a series of lectures that are generative in some regards, in that the text is there, but it may be combined and recombined in some way, and is also notated in terms of how we will be reading it. So, and using an animated music notation. And so we will do that for a while. It will probably not end, which is part of the idea, sort of continuous, persistent compositional practices. And following that, I'll do a very brief look at some other works I've done with animated notation and place of music and things like that. And it will absolutely be done. Time. Okay, so I think that's everything I wanted to say. So, and if you feel that the lights can be something else that works for me or for the vibe,
the San Francisco vibe.
Contact is
predetermined and distributed between both.
of two objects.
This talk will focus on
for two
topic
objects to make contact or respective visual representations. Must be defined and at least one must demonstrate dynamic qualities.
One potential outcome.
Ideally, it is or it isn't, and this distinction should be readily perceptible.
That features visual dynamism beyond the former.
Certain constraints regarding collision may be relaxed.
To control their actions.
Where the limitations of the instrument reduce the performer's physical ability, to control their actions.
Actualizing the moment of contact is not dependent on
reactions to certain stimuli.
Control
actualizing the moment of contact is not dependent on digital
media. Do provide a method whereby these interactions
but
can be clearly
media
actualized.
Do provide a method whereby these interactions can be clearly actualized.
Describes a score that features visual dynamism beyond performer interaction.
Generative notational context. Certain activations may be accomplished through the intentional obfuscation of symbolic design, context, and interaction.
Is predetermined and distributed between both speakers.
A soft contact or firm contact.
Ideally, is or it isn't.
This pronounced words
is
delightfully
perceptible.
As our negligible differences
accomplished the intentional obfuscation of symbolic design context. Extending the present moment.
A constraint, a extent, and leads
definition of contact?
It is the micro diversity slash conceptual singularity that I am most interested in.
Vulnerability and conceptual adherence.
A formal atomic analysis may clarify this distinction.
Or represents the work.
Extending the present moment requires atomic precision.
Primary distinguishing factor between dynamic and static or fixed
microdiversity.
Contact is
a inconsistent
collision or intersection of two objects.
Stable pitch relationships.
The actualization of constrained processes as notation.
Constrained dynamics.
Each iteration of the score represents the work.
The secondary primitive enhances or embellishes the primary. functionality may or may not rely on functionality by other aggregates. Dynamic score, which enforced by
the dynamic scores
now knowing on
it. Replaced the role of the conductor holes.
These thoughts referenced here in particularly dramatic fashion have been of concern to me
in such a
reference
way.
To my work.
Specificity, interpretation, presentation, and control.
And has led to certain clarifications regarding my
content
approaches to notation design.
Most often actualized as
audience perception
or reactions to certain stimuli.
Specificity, interpretation, presentation, and control.
My notational considerations regarding A, M, and N development include stability, performability, and conceptual audience. Consistently inconsistent densities.
While the primary goal of any composer is to successfully realize some compositional concept. My project has also been to research the notational solutions
to these
concepts.
A divisive entity.
A flexible relationship between the severe limitations of A and its impact on compositional speculation.
Not reducible to simple, unambiguous symbols.
I'm just going to show a couple other examples, but if it wasn't clear, the idea was to give a talk on animated notation using animated notation that described how the score itself was working as an example of animated notation. If I went back and listened, I don't know if that would make sense, but it's like something like that. So, PowerPoint. Okay, here we go. N and G talk. Okay.
do the thing.
Oh, neat. Okay, so so I'm just gonna, like I said, just run through a couple pieces really quick that I've worked on in the last couple of years that give a sort of different understanding. So the first piece, study number 8 from almost 3 years ago, had to do with trying to basically make a phase piece for 15 percussionists. So the way it started, everybody's in unison, and they all slowly speed up at different rates, and then they sustain all those different tempi for several minutes, and then at the end all slow down at different rates, all stopping at the same time but slowing down at a different pace. So this to me seemed like a really difficult thing to do, and for me was kind of like the personally breakthrough moment to see, oh, this stuff kind of works and can make very complex things very easy to play. It's about 12 minutes long. I'll play 3 sections, one where they start to desynchronize, one where they are sustaining multiple tempi, and then the last one is when they're starting to slow down. Metal section, this is the wood section. So as you can imagine, this would be devilishly difficult to notate conventionally and to read. This is a more recent piece installed at MPAC in Troy, New York. It's not a great documentation, but it's shot from on top, and the notation is being projected down onto 15 white circles in wood. In the center of each circle is a bell, and there's a converging circle that comes in, and that's the moment that you hit the bell. And so this was a sort of an audience interactive type of piece. So the idea for this piece was to put the notation in a more installation, not quite sound art, but maybe close to that context. So these platters are about this high, and hopefully it's sort of clear what's going on. The circle is, maybe 15 feet wide or something. Okay. Hustling. All right, so we talked a little bit about, in our talk, if you caught it, electroacoustic synchronization, which is so what was happening when we were speaking the words is that more often than not, a sound would be triggered at the moment the attack person would reach a node, so we would say, at the moment it's also triggering a sound. So the score is being read both by us and also by Max Patch in this case. And so this piece is doing the same thing for seven triangles. And like the last piece, it's generative, it runs for any length of time, and will be sort of continually inconsistent. This is also an example of the parts of the score being integrated into a more cohesive whole. And so each one of those sort of barbell things is an on and then a loop. This uses conventional notation, so fixed, you know, Eurocentric Western notation, in a, so I would say, kind of a shuffle context. So there's some number of small little precomposed fragments, anywhere from one note long, a long or short note long, if that makes sense, to, let's say, what would be equivalent to a couple measures. And these are continually recombined, as you'll see in this video, and then there's a line that moves across, so the playhead, swiping playhead, as Sight Cat Hope would say, and when it gets to the end of the line, you'll see the notation, it'll shuffle and pick from a database of these precomposed elements. Some ways, sort of a set of variations without a theme in some regard. So this one has no sound, but it will have sound in a minute. So what's happening here is you see the numbers, this each of these aggregates corresponds to one player, and every time one of these circles hits the top node at 12 o'clock, they play a note, and they pick their own pitch scheme. If it's followed by that thick arc, and they sustain it, and then what happens occasionally is that a line connects from a number into the center node, and then what you get are sort of more, all the performers share the same tempo in some sort of a pulse. So at some point everything's going to speed up, or we can just imagine that that happened and move on. But so the score looks something like this for this recording. The point of it is to kind of sort of hear how it speeds up, and then at some point the ensemble coalesces in this weird sort of pulsing that falls apart. So it's trying to find ways to deal with time that would be, I think, challenging from a realistic standpoint, using fixed notation. Speed up and slow down very gradually, independent of any of the other parts. And in theory, it's extendable pieces like these to any number of instruments. And then there's further functionality where here they start moving, so that you are out of time and then you're suddenly in unison with another player. This sort of thing. So infinitely, hopefully, combinable. Okay, very quickly. So the other project I do is. I've run a website, animatednotation.com, which sort of maps this field, of which I'm a part of, but also a fan of. This is a small sort of screen capture just of the, I don't know, 100 or so composers that I think fall into this primarily dynamic score category, but for now, using animated notation as a kind of colloquial term. And that's it. Thanks so much.